preview. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
3, 2, 1.
Family, Bible Buzz family, to the Bible family, Zoe Center family. This is the intro for 127 Bible Buzz, and then tomorrow will be the last one when we start the new chapter. So let's see real quick.
You better believe the topic was not the gospel.
And you will receive the desires of your heart.
Oh, that's interesting.
Don't you like that?
The topic was not, come and have your sins forgiven.
Yeah, and I also feel that things that I repetitively think about or say, I'm able to manifest.
Come and repent and believe, no.
But most people can't sustain that level of discipline to manifest the things that they want in their life.
You know what it was. Come get your blessing.
I want to talk to you today about how your words become your reality.
Come get your miracle.
If you don't believe in God, like, this story is just crazy because, boom, went from 700,000 to 3 million. Sick. And it's just like,
come get your deliverance.
I am Christian. That's not what we stand for.
Come get your... And the list goes on and on. These are the things that thousands flock to.
Producer Alec Baldwin has been charged in her death.
And I said, if you think of the money we create as a commodity.
I'll adore you. I treat you like milk. I'll do nothing but spoil you.
I could call you my baby. Torita,
Torita.
Hyundai, with the grand opening of our 14th dealership, Hyundai Santa Monica. View the inventory for all 14.
By stepping up and doing a dollar a day. And it always feels so strange to bring it back to money, but that's, unfortunately, that's where the world goes. That's how we spend the world, man. We are asking you to come in here right now. and do a dollar a day, $30 a month. Do it for the Sarahs of the world, but more importantly, do it for you and your loved ones.
800-525-5683 or klove.com. And if you can have one scoop of ice cream, why not have two?
Hey, so here sign we go.
We're going to double it up. And this is the really, really fun part. Because giving, there's a lot of joy in that. Sometimes it's hard to make that initial decision, but once it happens, you're like, yeah. So if you're one of these 60, the final 60 needed at $30 a month to keep your K-Love on the air, this double up opportunity, you're going to receive an exclusive K-Love thank you t-shirt.
Yeah,
first
man.
Time we've ever done it.
Never done it before.
And here, it's a little bit exciting.
Yes.
Even more so.
Yes.
A friend of K-Love has said, you know what? I'd like to donate a $2,000 Walmart shopping spree. So yeah, you'll buddy. Also be in to win. You'll be one of the very first in and one of the very last because literally in minutes, somebody's going to be winning that. And it's our double way of saying you are amazing and your gift matters. And thank you, thank you, thank you.
We've had so many folks step up in a big, big way, handing out those big old gifts. And for that, we have to say thank you as well.
Yes.
Franklin is in Crockett, California, doing $1,200. Earlier this morning, Miss Deanna in Milwaukee and a $10,000 gift.
Man.
Right now, there is someone listening who has been blessed by this ministry, who has been blessed by God, maybe having a great year in business. You can match that $10,000. You can do it.
We're all in different places, right? Financially.
We all are.
And so your gift may look different than others. If you can do that $10,000 one-time gift, thank you. Thank you. It makes a difference. Now, are you saying, what about $30 a month? Does that really matter?
Absolutely.
Yes, it makes
does.
A huge difference. And you are needed right now, the final 60 to say, yeah, I can do a dollar a day. Because when I'm struggling and when I feel anxious and overwhelmed, I can turn on my K-Love. I know it's a safe place. I know it's going to reconnect me with God if I feel like maybe things aren't where they need to be. 800-525-5683.
Can I back up just for a second?
Please.
This may be tremendously silly, but I'm a tremendously silly person. Can I just geek out about that K-Love t-shirt for 5 seconds?
Go ahead.
I mean, okay. All right. Now, come on, Amy Jo. Talk
no.
to me. How geeked do you get if you're walking down the street and someone walks by with
yes.
an Iowa t-shirt on?
Every time I call out, like, where are you from? I want to talk to them about, because I'm from Iowa. I want to talk to them about Iowa.
And of course, you know, anybody wears anything that has the halo on it, the angels on it, I'm all over. I am all Sweet. Over you.
Loves baseball.
I
yep.
love my baseball.
Yep.
Think about when you're walking down the street, or you're at the grocery store, or you're at a meeting at school, and someone else comes strolling in and they're wearing that K-Love t-shirt.
Yes.
What that tells you is, man, I am part of this family of God. I think that is so cool. We want to represent. We want to be part of something together.
Yes.
Why not be part of this ministry that's blessing so many people every day?
I guarantee in that t-shirt, you're probably going to receive a lot of hugs and yep. probably a lot of fist bumps. And there's going to be a lot of questions too, which can open the door to a lot of really great things, having
that's
those
fun.
God conversations. But the t-shirt, just a little way for
that
us to
it,
say
man.
Thank you, because we're just so grateful, blown away by your generosity that you would give to a radio station. Every day, Skip and I stand here and say,
wow.
Man, you are incredible. So thank you. Still looking for that first one person to say, I'll do $30 a month. Spots open for 60.
Okay.
This song to count you in. We get it. Your week is wrapping up. Things are crazy busy, but your K-Love is not funded yet, and you are needed at this moment. Don't let it pass you by. And yes, you're going to get the thank you t-shirt. And yes, you're in to win this $2,000 Walmart shopping spree. But more than that, it's your K-Love. It's your peace. It's the hope. It's the way that God talks to you through this music. So thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
800-525-5683. K-Love.com. You know what the ask is, $30 a month, a dollar a day. If you'd want to do that, $360 as a
yeah,
single gift, yeah,
works.
Bring it. That works.
Come on.
T-shirt's yours. In to win the Walmart shopping spree to be given away very soon.
I
this
love that.
Is your last opportunity to take advantage of this.
Hey, I love this too. Huh. Nicole, she's bumping it up, and now she was already giving, and she's bumped it up, and now she's doing that $30 a month. So, Nicole, that t-shirt's coming your way. That works too if you want to increase your gift if you've already been giving. Thank you.
800-525-5683. Okay, no more messing around. Got to do this. Is this the day you make that commitment? A dollar a day.
Yes, come on.
You know, I am embarrassed to say over the past week, I have blown $30 on silly, silly,
cereal.
Silly things.
Cereal.
Okay, that was $7.50, and it was a BOGO. So you really can't hang me up for that one, because I got twice the cereal for the same amount.
And listen, it's okay. Go out and buy your cereal, but then think of the opportunity to give to keep your Caleb on the air and what that investment means. You're not blowing the money. It's going into something eternal.
Okay.
That's awesome.
800-525-5683. The Caleb T-shirt, yours. $30 a month, yours. In to win the $2,000 Walmart shopping spree to be given away in a matter of minutes, yours. But you've got to make the commitment. 800-525-5683, Caleb.com.
Looking for that final 60, $30 a month, 800-525-5683 or Caleb.com. Is there room for you? Yes, a whole lot of room. You are needed right now at $30 a month, Caleb.com.
Dare to imagine, dare to believe in a true love that gave us a brand new beginning. No room for a king, no celebration and no ceremony. In that little town, no, nobody will think. This is the story of the coming glory. Can you hear the prayers the people pray? Can you see the skies begin to break? When heaven and earth were face to face, oh, how the world forever changed. For God is with us.
When I know that my $15 that I can give is appreciated and asked for. Thank you guys so much.
Gloria. Oh. Gloria, thank you.
Gloria.
Thank you. You know, there's that feeling. And if, you know, I make it no secret whatsoever that I dealt with huge, huge issues of self-worth and value and that sort of thing as a kid. And when I walked into the First Baptist Church of Westminster and they threw their arms open and they brought me in and they made me feel included.
Yes. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
It has an impact on me. It brings tears in my eyes even now, yes. man. That feeling all of a sudden, that, you know, for so long you stood on the outside and you looked in and you just wondered, man, you tell yourself, I don't need that. I don't need that. I'm fine without you. I don't need that. But then you realize, man, all of a sudden there's a longing and there's a feeling and there's a sense of unfulfillment. But when you step in like Miss Gloria and you feel it, man, I feel included.
Yes.
Every song takes on new meaning. Every story takes on deeper meaning. Every victory, every heartbreak is that much more intense because now I'm part of that. And this is the time for you to step in and be part of it.
And maybe you never even realized this before. So many people will say, wait, I didn't realize that K-Love was listener funded. Yes. And this is your opportunity. We're raising money to keep your K-Love on the air. And we're asking, will you give? K-Love.com is one place. The number you call is 800-525-5683. We're looking for the final 22 at $10 a month to say yes.
It's easy.
800-525-5683 and to say I'm included. Most people can join at that level. Yep. Now, if you can do a little bit more and take a couple of spots,
hallelujah,
that works too. But thank you. There's room for you. The arms wide open saying, come on in.
Come on in. Water's fine. There's plenty of room for all y'all. And that feeling when you do make that commitment, and I guarantee it because I experienced it and so many people who have given in the past experienced it. The feeling is almost immediate. It's immediate. You feel the weight of doubt just kind of fall away. Then all of a sudden you realize your eyes are clear. Your head, it's like a shot of oxygen just rushing through your body. And you feel like, wait a minute, I just did something incredible. And it's a simple, it's $10. It's less than 50 cents a day. It's making the commitment and saying, I'm part of this.
Let's add a little cherry to the top of all this.
Okay.
This gets a little exciting here.
Okay.
So we're saying, yep, you're included. Come on in at $10 a month to keep your K-Love on the air. We get it. Your week's wrapping up and K-Love not yet funded yet. So if you can help by doing this $10 a month right now, you're going to be in to win a donated $2,000 Walmart shopping spree. That's coming from a friend that wants to inspire you to give. You're going to be one of the very last in. We started it a while ago, just a couple songs back.
Yeah, man.
Now we're saying we're about to pick the winner. Would love for you to win this $2,000 Walmart shopping spree. 800-525-5683.
We have some folks that are stepping out and taking a big old lead this morning saying, hey, I've got your $10. How about if I turn that into $1,000? Kelly is in Atlanta. Thank you so much. So many people stepping in. $360, just a one-time gift. $1,000 one-time gift. $5,000 earlier this morning. $20,000 in a single gift. Miss Deanna.
Yeah.
Look, if that's not you, we understand. That $10, we celebrate right alongside you.
Yes.
But if you want to step out and take the lead and say, yes, this is my home. This is where I belong. And you can do $5,000, bring it. If you can do $1,000, bring it. This is the time. A $2,000 shopping spree, maybe you can match that $2,000. Say, all right there, Mr. Happy Donor, giving away a Walmart shopping spree. I got your $2,000 right there.
And how good does that feel when you give and you know what you're investing in? So what are you investing in? More Jesus, more Jesus, and more Jesus. I can't think of anything else that I want to invest in, but more Jesus. And that's what you're doing at this $10 a month level, 800-525-5683 or klove.com.
Let's take a second. Let's dial it back here for just a moment because, you know, hey, time's ticking and we have a shopping spree to give away in just a few minutes.
Right.
We want you to be in on this. Let's take time. We have room both on the phones at klove.com, 800-525-5683 and on the phone at klove.com because you're using the phone anyway.
Thank you.
That's what you call left-handed luck. Here we go. There's room for you right now. This is an opportunity. Minutes away from a $2,000 Walmart shopping spree. You've been thinking about doing it and you're thinking, I'll do it after work with Scott and Kelly. This day's going to get away from you and you're going to forget and the opportunity is going to be gone. So let's go now. 800-525-5683. Klove.com. Klove.com.
And why? What are you investing in? I said it earlier, but there's nothing greater than investing in more hope, more peace, more Jesus, more Jesus, more Jesus. That's what this is all about. Every time you turn on your Klove, you have that hope and that encouragement. 800-525-5683.
Okay. Amy Jo? Not quite there yet.
Okay. So that means there is room for you.
Opportunity not.
And oftentimes people step back at this level saying, oh, somebody else I'm sure will jump in. This is your moment. You know if God's speaking to you.
That's it.
And just respond to that. 800-525-5683.
800-525-5683. Here we go. You ready? One more push and then we got to go.
If you say so.
You ready? Here we go. Time is knocking. Time is running out. This is your last opportunity. Ready?
One more time.
Okay.
We're looking for you at $10 a month to keep your Klove on the air. 800-525-5683.
Ready? Here we go.
Three, two, really?
800-525-5683. Time is running out. We would need to hear from you. Your only opportunity before a $2,000 Walmart shopping spree is given away. But you've got to act right now.
More of that hope, more of that peace and that encouragement. Klove.com, you are needed. 800-525-5683.
We've never said thank you like this before. The Klove exclusive thank you t-shirt. This t-shirt is a thank you gift for helping to fund your Klove and keep the hope flowing through the speakers every single day. When you give at a level of $30 a month or more, or give a single special gift of $360 or more, you'll receive this exclusive Klove t-shirt, a wearable reminder of the station you love to listen to and support. Make your gift now while there's still time at klove.com.
Hey friends, Chris Tomlin here.
I will tell of your wonders, sing of your grace. The God of creation knows me by name. The Lord is faithful, yesterday, now, and always, always.
Did you know that Klove is a listener-supported station? So what does that mean? That means it stays on the air because of people like you. And when you give, it helps bring songs of hope and encouragement that just blast through the speakers and bring people closer to Jesus all across this nation. How amazing is that? So here's how you do it. Simple number. If you want to give to this number. It is 1-800-525-5683. 1-800-525-5683. Or go to Klove.com. And remember to give. And remember, no matter the amount, every gift matters. It takes all of us. So God bless you.
Your $30 a month gift keeps Klove playing the right song at the right time. Give now on your phone or tablet at klove.com.
I know that.
Don't be historical or hysterical. Control your emotions. Don't bring up things from the distant past. You know, 1 Corinthians 13 says, love does not keep a record of the wrongs that are done. So when you say, well, I remember 25 years ago when you said, like, seriously, it's time to put the past in the past. These are some of the insights that you're going to find in this new book from Levi and his wife, Jenny, on the topic of marriage. It's called The Marriage Devotional. It's a thick book. It has 52 devotions for you to go through with your spouse. It's going to be a blessing. You could do them on your dates together. You can do them in the morning or the evening. You can read it on your own and compare notes however you like. But we want to send you a copy for your gift of any size this month to a new beginning. It's The Marriage Devotional by Levi and Jenny Lesko.
Yeah, and thanks so much for your generosity.
It's your investments that help us continue to bring Pastor Greg's studies to you each day. It's the only way we can cover the costs of broadcasting. And when you donate today, please do ask for the Marriage Devotional. You can call us at 1-800-821-3300. We can take your call anytime. That's 1-800-821-3300. Or go online to harvest.org. Well, next time, more from Pastor Greg's encouraging study in Romans chapter 1 called Everybody Needs Jesus. Join us here on A New Beginning with pastor and Bible teacher Greg Laurie.
A New Beginning is sponsored by Harvest Christian Fellowship. I'm Donna Rush with SoCal's Morning Rush. You know, as we get closer to the weekend, I hope you have plans to worship with your church family. And if you're near Harvest Riverside or Harvest Orange County, well, you're invited to join Pastor Greg Laurie. Sunday morning services are at 9 and 11 a.m. Find out all about Harvest at harvest.org. You know, when we have that relationship with Jesus Christ, like Pastor Laurie was talking about, what flows out of that is a desire to do good works that glorify Him. And you know what, dear KKLA family, you can do that right now by letting our persecuted brothers and sisters in Christ know that we hear their cries and that we will respond right now.
One.
I have with me Rob Anthony with International Christian Response. Good morning, Rob.
Morning. Donna, we're seeing more and more extreme persecution and violence against Christians in places like Afghanistan, Nigeria, so many countries that are hostile towards our brothers and sisters in Christ. Yeah. They're thrown in jail, abused for their faith. And in these places, ICR has a network of local churches to rescue and provide safety, food, and care for those that are in hiding.
Amen.
And this is where you step in and say, yes, I can provide love and hope to my fellow believers.
Here's how you do that. It's $39 a month. That will provide ongoing safety, food, and care for a persecuted Christian every single month. Or if you just want to do a one-time donation, $234, that will provide 6 months of safety, food, and care for a persecuted Christian. That's the average length of stay, by the way, until a person can be relocated into a new home and or maybe even country if necessary. 6 months. Here's the number again, 888-448-4485. Again, 888-448-4485. This is our final morning with ICR to partner with them, so please do this morning. We are ready for your call, 888-448-4485. Let's not leave a single persecuted Christian who needs that help behind. You can also give that gift online right now at kkla.com.
Find hope here. 99.5 KKLA.
Inflation is pushing up the cost of just about everything. Food, gas, clothing. But life insurance, which thanks to inflation you need now more than ever, actually costs less today than it did a few years ago. Now is the time to get the insurance you need at a price you can afford. Call SelectQuote now and we'll help you save more than 50% on term life insurance. In a hurry? Don't worry. With SelectQuote, you can get up to $2 million in instant, same-day coverage with no medical exam. That's right, get up to $2 million in instant, affordable, same-day coverage with no medical exam in under an hour.
Call SelectQuote now at 1-800-507-2266. That's 1-800-507-2266. Or go to SelectQuote.com now and get up to $2 million in instant, same-day coverage with no medical exam. That's 1-800-507-2266.
Full details on example policies at selectquote.com/commercials.
Listen on Odyssey. Celebrating the life and legacy of Dr. Charles Stanley. This is KKLA-FM, Los Angeles. KKLA-FM Los Angeles. Find hope here.
Oh, this is our final day of rescue for persecuted Christians through ICR. Here's how you can help right now. 888-448-4485. $39 a month. Rescues our persecuted brothers and sisters in Christ are at kkla.com. Through the Bible is sponsored by Thru the Bible Radio Network. Dr. McGee is in Nehemiah chapter 10.
Dr. McGee, a
approved of rock and roll festivals? Well, that may come as a shock to many of you. I know it would be to me, but we'll hear more about it today on Through the Bible. I'm Steve Schwetz, inviting you aboard the Bible bus for our final study in Nehemiah. And as you turn to chapter 10, Greg and I have got an exciting update from North Africa.
Yes, Steve, this week our World Prayer Team is traveling through North Africa, and we want to focus today on our Kabyle ministry, which is primarily received in Algeria and Morocco. And, you know, there's a lot of prayer needed for these fellow passengers on the Bible bus. They're studying Dr. McGee's teaching in their mother tongue. Both of these nations are Muslim-dominant, very few people reached with the gospel, and a very low tolerance for those who believe in Christ. Persecution is a big reality. So
yeah.
challenging place, but lots of exciting fruit.
Yeah, let's start with a man in Algeria. Here's what he says. We wish you happiness and prosperity in the glorious work you do every day. The gospel of Jesus Christ blooms each day in the gardens of our hearts. That's a beautiful picture.
That is.
Of course, there are plenty of problems because the evil spirit of the world is extremely annoyed. Consequently, we sometimes face fierce battles, but we are encouraged, for it is the word of Jesus that is confirmed when he said we would have problems but should fear nothing. To Jesus be glory and victory through all ages. Amen. I leave you, my dear friends, in the peace of the Lord.
And Steve, I think we're going to notice joy in the midst of very difficult circumstances. And one of the most humbling things I've seen in working in ministry around the world is people who are suffering for their faith and yet have real joy. Here's another one from Algeria. Thank you for your radio broadcasts. God the Father has blessed us with his true word of truth. In our village, the sun has risen. The empire of darkness has been destroyed. The enemy of our souls is agitated. He tries everything to trouble us, but he has lost all his power. Christ is king. Hallelujah. Thank you to all of you, servants of Jesus.
Boy, that sounds like a movie trailer for like an action-packed, I don't know what.
Yeah.
That man has a future if he ever wants to come to Hollywood and start as a writer. That is a beautiful picture.
And I bet, even though I don't know this for a fact, Steve, I bet if we walked a week in that man's shoes, we'd say he has terrible problems. He has suffering.
Yeah.
And listen to the victory that he has in his faith in Christ. Incredible.
Yeah, the difficulty of living in Algeria, I don't have a concept of it. I've never been there, but and I know that most of us don't, but yet this man has the joy of Jesus Christ in his heart.
And just before you read this last letter, we want to remind our listening family, this is the privilege. We get to bring the Word of God, the light of Jesus Christ, into these dark places.
And you get to be praying for him by joining our World Prayer Team. Go on to ttb.org/pray. You'll be glad you did. Next, we've got a husband and wife with two children. Here's what this husband says. Since my youth, I was a good Muslim in my eyes. I say in my eyes, but in the eyes of God the Father, it turned out that I was lost and lived in absolute error. I had a tendency to look for soothing music on my radio. Here's the pivot point. One day, a number of years ago, by God's providence, I came across your radio program in my mother tongue. Then I heard a man who said, "You who are tired and burdened, come to me. I will give you rest." Then he explained that it was a call of Jesus Christ in the Bible for all humanity. It touched me deeply, and an indescribable peace settled throughout my whole being. I gave my heart to Jesus. Since that day, we've been listening every night, and we have given the frequency to our close relatives and neighbors. An imam of our former mosque converted to Christ, and he said, "Radio knocked down the tables, as Jesus did at the Temple of Jerusalem when he chased the merchants." We praise God for these miracles.
Steve, even though I get the privilege of being in this work every day, a letter like that just almost knocks me off my feet.
Yeah, for those of you who aren't familiar with what an imam is, it's basically a Muslim pastor or priest, the equivalent.
Right.
And that's the teacher in the mosque. And this guy converts to Christianity.
And this is not an isolated testimony. We heard one last week at a meeting of an imam in Africa who spent 3 years. He'd go to his study to open the Bible and the Quran and listen to the broadcast because it was the only safe place for him.
Yeah,
and
so encouraging.
Yeah, it's just, I hope we all are rejoicing right now in the power of God.
Yeah, let me pray for us. Heavenly Father, we pray for our brothers and sisters in Algeria and all around the world in those especially difficult places. Be with them, Lord. Give them ears to hear your word. Pray that you would call many to yourself. Pray that you would bless the program as it goes out now. In Jesus' name, amen. Here's Through the Bible with Dr. J. Vernon McGee.
Now, friends, as we come today to this final study, we saw last time that they read in the Bible, read in the Old Testament, then they confessed their sin, and then they met in a great praise service to God. And I got so carried away with praising God because he's a creator, I forgot to just say that as you go on through this chapter, they thank God for the redemption that came to them when the Lord led their people out of Egypt. And those are the two things you and I ought to thank God for. He's the creator. This is his universe. And we ought to thank him that he saved us. By the way, have you thanked him today that he saved you? Have you told him that you love him? Don't wait till Sunday morning to go to church to sing the doxology right where you are right now. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Because he's the creator, he's given me everything that's material and physical. I thank him for it. He has saved me a sinner, and I thank him for it. How wonderful it is. Now, we saw that these people signed on the dotted line. They made a covenant with God. Have you ever made a covenant with him? Have you ever promised him anything? You ought to. And a great many people ought to do that. You have the list of them here, and believe me, the list is just written down here. You know, these people now are bringing to the Lord their first fruits. And you have here the offerings. They hadn't been bringing them. Now they're bringing them to the Lord. This new group of people are coming. When I hear today a church that's always complaining about not having enough money, and I hear any Christian organization, that'd be this broadcast. And for goodness sakes, let's don't blame people for non-support. Let's go fishing, as Simon Peter did for the Lord Jesus to get the tax money. Let's go out and win some more folk to the Lord. Get more sheep. Then you can shear them, by the way. And my point is, I don't think you ought to support anything. I don't care what it is. Unless it's a blessing to you. Unless it's opened up to you a great avenue of service. We ought to support the place and the thing that's giving us our blessing. Where do you get your blessing, friend? Wherever it is, that's what you ought to support, by the way. My, this is very practical. This is Nehemiah, you know, great layman that he was. Now we find here another great list in chapter 11. And they are listed here. The others made a covenant with God and kept it. Well, these are just willing people. They're going to do what God wants them to do. Listen to just the first few verses. And the rulers of the people dwelt at Jerusalem. The rest of the people also cast lots to bring one of 10 to dwell in Jerusalem, the holy city, and 9 parts to dwell in other cities. They cast lots. 1 in 10 would stay in Jerusalem. And the one who got the short straw, I guess, stayed in Jerusalem, or the long straw. And the others, other 9 went out and dwelt in other cities. Well, I guess there could have been a lot of complaining and say, oh, me, why did God let this happen to me, you know? But notice, and the people blessed all the men that willingly offered themselves to dwell at Jerusalem. Well, may I say to you, a lot of people wanted to move out to the suburban areas, as you can see even in that day. But those that were willing to dwell at Jerusalem, they just thanked God for it, just to be willing, friend. My, the Lord records a willing heart. Notice this. Now, these are the chief of the province that dwelt in Jerusalem. But in the cities of Judah dwelt everyone in his possession, their cities to wit. And then here's the list given. Oh, God takes note of the willing hearts of people. Isn't that wonderful? Now, that brings us over to the 12th chapter. And what do you have in the 12th chapter? Another list, you say. Right, but who are these? Well, these are those that are just praising God, just praising God. I used to go visit a lady that was going blind and in a wheelchair part of the time, right here in Pasadena. She lived here in Pasadena, and I was pastor here years ago. And this dear lady, you say, needed to be comforted and helped. Well, to tell the truth, I don't think she did. But I did need help in those days. I was a young preacher, and I went by just to listen to her. You know why? My, how she could praise God. And here's a list of those praise God. I imagine She's in this list somewhere now. I don't have the latest. God keeps that record, but I'm confident that he has those. Now we have the dedication of the walls of Jerusalem. They've now had all of this take place. We're told verse 27. And at the dedication of the wall of Jerusalem, they sought the Levites out of all their places to bring them to Jerusalem to keep the dedication with gladness, both with thanksgivings and with singing, with cymbals, psalteries, and with harps. My, they had a great time there. And the sons of the singers gathered themselves together both out of the plain country round about Jerusalem from the village. So they brought together all the musicians. They had a great rock festival. Now somebody's going to say, wait a minute, preacher, you ought to be careful saying that. No, I don't mind saying it, and I'll tell you why. I heard a man say the other day, because there were others criticizing the rock festivals. Oh, he said, I believe as a Christian in the rock and roll festival. Everybody looked at him in amazement and said, what do you mean? Well, he says, I believe in the rock festival, rock of ages, cleft for me, let me hide myself in thee. And I believe in the roll, too. When the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Now, that's the kind of rock and roll I'm talking about. That's what they had here, you see. These are the ones inscribed in the Lamb's Book of Life, and they're now going to meet and dedicate the walls of Jerusalem. Now, Nehemiah brought up from all over the land the people for this dedication, because Jerusalem was the city where the temple was. Verse 40. So stood the two companies of them that gave thanks in the house of God, and I and half of the rulers with me. Now he lists the priests. They were all there. Verse 43. Now will you listen to this? Also that day they offered great sacrifices and rejoiced, for God had made them rejoice with great joy. The wives also and the children rejoiced, so that the joy of Jerusalem was heard even afar off. Now, strangers passing through that land, visitors, tourists, they heard this great shout of praise and joy. And they said, what in the world's going on over there? And when you hear that sort of thing, you always want to go. I know I was up north in the Oakland area and went by that big stadium that is there, and they were playing some, I don't actually know who's playing there, but they were having a baseball game. And I want to tell you, one place there, somebody understood, hit a home run, and what a shout went up from that place. And I thought at the time, my, I'd like to be over there seeing that. That must be an exciting game. That's a natural reaction, you see. And I thought at the time, my, if where I'm preaching, if I could get that kind of a shout to go up so that the whole community would hear it, I have a notion a lot of people would come around and want to know what's going on. You know, one of the reasons they pass us by today in the churches is because they think we're a dead lot and a boring lot. And the interesting thing is, 9 times out of 10, they're right. Oh, there ought to be more joy of the Lord in our services today. That is the thing that's needed. Real joy. There's nothing that has a power, a joy. That actually, we said the other day, and we're going to see it when we get to Philippians, that the very source of power is joy. And that's what, you remember Nehemiah said? Joy of the Lord is your strength. And if you're a crybaby Christian, you're not going to have much of a testimony at all. Dear lady told me one time, she said, my husband is unsaved, and she says, not McGee, I just can't reach him, and she began to blubber right there. She said, I speak to him at breakfast of a morning, and I weep and tell him how much I love him and I want him saved. And then again at supper, she does the same thing. You know, I got thinking about that. Would you want to have breakfast and dinner with a weeping woman? I don't know about you, I wouldn't. I don't think I'd enjoy that. Wouldn't help your indigestion. And I have a notion that fellow was pretty sick of it. So I told her after that, I said, look, I have a suggestion. Why don't you just quit talking to him at breakfast and dinner? Oh, she said, you'd mean quit witnessing? I said, yes, quit witnessing like you're witnessing. And let's witness another way. Start praying for him and stop weeping before him. Because that, you know, the joy of the Lord is your strength. We need to keep that in mind also. Now we come to the 13th chapter, and again we see the demonstration that eternal vigilance is the price of freedom, and it's the price of Christian liberty, and it's the price of Christian freedom too, by the way. Now will you notice, Nehemiah, somewhere in this interval between here and chapter 13, went back to his job in the palace at Shushan. You see, he'd only asked for a leave of absence. Now, after he had been away, I don't know how long, maybe a year, maybe 2 years, he asked for another leave, and he came back to Jerusalem. Now, what did he find out? They weren't keeping that separation that they should have. On that day, they read in the book of Moses in the audience of the people, and therein was found written that the Ammonite and the Moabite should not come into the congregation of God forever. That's way back in the 25th of Deuteronomy. Now they read that, and they decided that the thing to do was to obey the word of God, because they met not the children of Israel with bread, with water, but hired Balaam against them, that he should curse them. Howbeit our God turned the curse into a blessing. Now it came to pass, when they had heard the law, that they separated from Israel all the mixed multitude. Now they had in their crowd a whole lot of the Ammonites and Moabites, and they weren't obeying God in this. Now they put them out of the land. Now we read verse 4, and before this, Eliashib the priest, having the oversight of the chamber of the house of our God, was allied unto Tobiah. Here was the high priest, through a marriage of his son or daughter, to the house of Tobiah. In other words, the high priest himself disobeyed God in this important matter. Now what has happened? God had forbidden this, that they were to intermarry with these, and he'd given them, I think, a very humorous illustration of it, a real cartoon, by the way. He said, you should never hitch together, plow together, an ox and an ass. You see, an ox is a clean beast, ass is an unclean beast, and you're not to yoke them together. And a believer and an unbeliever shouldn't be yoked together. I know a man in business today paying an awful price for a partnership that he made before he got his eyes open. May I say to you, it's true not only in that, but in marriage today. Now, will you notice what happened? Why, he had prepared for him a great chamber, where aforetime they laid the meat offerings, the frankincense, and the vessels. In other words, they had storage places in the temple, and they had a big room. Now, they no longer bring the offerings in that. They cleaned out that room, and they put on a nice shag rug and put in some lovely furniture and a king-size bed and invited old Tobiah in. And, in fact, they told him he could have it any time he wanted it. Now, what's this man Nehemiah's going to do? He's returned now. Well, will you notice this? But in all this time was not I at Jerusalem. Nehemiah had been there, that wouldn't have happened. For in the 32nd year of Artaxerxes, king of Babylon, came I unto the king, and after certain days obtained I leave of the king. I came to Jerusalem, and I understood of the evil that Eliashib did for Tobiah in preparing him a chamber in the courts of the house of God. And it grieved me so. Therefore I cast forth all the household stuff of Tobiah out of the chamber. You know, I love this man, Nehemiah. Nehemiah says, we're going to get rid of Tobiah. He's not going to be in the house of God. And the Lord Jesus commended the church in Ephesus because they always examined those who said they were apostles and were not, and they put them out. And so this man Nehemiah, he went in, got his suitcase, pitched it out the window, said, you're not staying here anymore. You're not going to get free rent here. Then I commanded, and they cleansed the chambers. They fumigated the place, you see. And thither brought I again the vessels of the house of God with the meat offering and the frankincense. And we put that room back for what it was originally intended, in the service of God. Well, he didn't stop there. He says, and I perceived that the portions of the Levites had not been given them, for the Levites and the singers that did the work were fled, every one to his field. Every man had to get a job that was a Levite that served in the temple outside, working the field. And God's service was neglected. Now, I believe that today, many a minister's being asked to do too much. Many a man's having to neglect his study because the church wants him to be an administrator and be everything else. He needs somebody to take this other responsibility. And I love Nehemiah, and I think now you'll begin to discover why. You know why? Well, because he said the preacher ought to have a raise. I always like men like that, and I hope you don't mind that, because that's exactly what Nehemiah said. And he said, you're going to bring in the tithe that belongs here and see that these men are taken care of, that are in the service of God. My, I love a man like that. And God approved it, by the way. Verse 14, remember me, O my God, concerning this, and wipe not out my good deeds that I've done for the house of my God and for the offices there. He said, just record this, O Lord, and God did. Here it is in the word of God. Now, he found out they were doing something else. They were breaking the Sabbath day. And what was happening was this. In those days saw I in Judah some treading wine presses on the Sabbath, bringing in sheaves, lading asses, as also wine, grapes, and figs, and all manner of burdens, which they brought into Jerusalem on the Sabbath day. I testified against them in the day wherein they sold victuals. There dwelt men of Tyre also, therein which brought fish and all manner of ware, and sold it on the Sabbath to the children of Judah. See, they came in from the sea coast. They brought fish. Then I contended with the nobles of Judah, said unto them, what evil thing is this that ye do and profane the Sabbath day? Now, they're under law, you see, and they're to obey God in this matter. Did not your fathers thus, and did not our God bring all this evil upon us, upon the city, yet ye bring forth wrath upon Israel by profaning the Sabbath? It came to pass that when the gates of Jerusalem began to be dark before the Sabbath, I commanded that the gates should be shut. I charged that they should not be opened till after the Sabbath. And some of my servants set out at the gates that there should no burden be brought in on the Sabbath day. Now notice what happened. Well, these men said, you know, that fella Nehemiah, he did it one or two times, but the gate will be open again. So the merchants and sellers of all kinds of ware lodged without Jerusalem once or twice. Then I testified against them and said unto them, why lodge ye about the wall? If ye do so again, I'll lay hands on you. From that time forth came they no more on the Sabbath. You see, Nehemiah closed the gate, and they came up there thinking it'd be open, and it wasn't. They just waited around, and Nehemiah crawled up on top to see if they were there. First Sabbath day, they were there. He came the second Sabbath day, climbed up and looked down, and there they were. So he said to them, look here, you come here again, I'm going to come out after you. Well, they didn't come back anymore because they knew he meant business. Now he found out, in those days also saw I Jews that had married wives of Ashdod, of Ammon, and of Moab. Verse 23. Now what does he do? Well, he contended with them. He cursed them. And that doesn't mean he's swearing at them, but he pronounced a curse upon them and smote certain of them, plucked off their hair, and made them swear by God, saying, ye shall not give your daughters to your son. Now, this man used extreme measures, but it needed that, my friend. And then I tell you, you see, revival will always lead to reformation. When you have a revival, it's going to clean up everything that needs cleaning up. The only way today that the problems that face our nation can be solved right now, and I say it rather categorically and dogmatically, is by a revival that'll come to the people of God. Nehemiah concludes by saying, verse 29, remember them, O my God, because they've defiled the priesthood and the covenant of the priesthood under the Levites. Thus cleansed I them from all strangers, and I appointed the wards of the priests and the Levites, every one in his business, and for the wood offering at times appointed, and for the first fruits. Listen to him, his final word. Remember me, O my God, for good. I'm sure God remembered him for good. And I remember him that way. I hope you do. I hope you love Nehemiah, great layman of God. Until next time, may God richly bless you, my beloved.
Till then, you can reach us at 1-800-65-BIBLE or at ttb.org. I'm Steve Schwetz, and I'll save you a seat on the Bible bus as we continue to roll through God's Word together.
Jesus made it home to heaven.
grateful for our committed listening family who faithfully pray and invest in Through the Bible as we together take the whole word to the whole world.
Today's pre-recorded program was sponsored by Through the Bible Radio Network. I'm Donna Rush with SoCal's Morning Rush. I am so thankful on this thankful Thursday that we live in a country where we can proclaim the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to share with you the story of Indira. We can't even mention where she lives for safety's sake.
My husband and our two children and I were happy. But our souls felt empty. We then learned about Jesus and accepted him as our Lord and Savior. Our families were furious. My own uncle even told me, if you do not forsake your God and reject him, I will ruin your life. You will beg me for mercy. But we stayed true to our faith. He then seized our property, and my mother-in-law once brutally beat me. So we fled. But we still didn't know where we would be safe as believers. When ICR heard about the situation, they provided us with a home and our basic needs to help us get back on our feet. It's such a blessing to finally feel safe again.
Rob Anthony is here with ICR. Rob, tell us quickly what happens when our dear persecuted brothers and sisters in Christ are rescued by ICR.
Yeah, they get safe housing. They get food, care through this network of churches and believers. They get a chance to give families like Indira's new identities and a new location. More than that, they get to experience a taste of what it's like to live out our faith freely, like you and I do every day.
Yes, here's how you can be a part of that right now, dear KKLA family. $39 a month provides ongoing safety, food, and care for one persecuted Christian every single month. Now, I know budgets can be tight right now, and maybe you want to just give a one-time gift. You can do that. $156 would cover 4 months of safety for a persecuted Christian like Indira. Here's how you can give that right now. 888-448-4485. We're partnering with them together. 888-448-4485. Or you can give that safety gift right now by going to kkla.com. Who will be the first to step up this morning for Indira and other precious brothers and sisters in Christ who are facing something very different than what we are when we wake up this morning? Yeah, 888-448-4485.
SoCal's Morning Rush.
A girl in Kenya dreams of becoming a doctor. An elder in Guatemala dreams of being part of a community. Reach out and change their world, and it will change your own. Unbound.org.
Hello, KKLA family. It's David James. If you're injured in an accident, call my friend and my own attorney, Dan Johnson, over at Burglar & Johnson. You realize insurance companies sometimes take us of faith and think we're pushovers? Dan, you've seen this?
Yes, several times. Over the years, Berglund & Johnson has had attorneys come to us that used to work for insurance companies, and they saw how poorly insurance companies treated people in an attempt to increase their profits. And I've seen that happen many times with people of faith, where they refuse to resolve the case fairly because they don't think the person of faith will go through with litigation. We at Berglund & Johnson know how to handle that to ensure that victims of serious personal injury and wrongful death obtain fair compensation for all of their damages, including the costs for medical treatment, loss of earnings, and pain and suffering that that person may suffer for the rest of their life.
Protect yourself and your family. Call Berglund & Johnson for a free evaluation. 1-800-4-IF-HURT. 1-800, the number 4, and the words if hurt.
Donna Rush here with Phil Liberatore, the IRS problem solver. Phil, I hear the IRS has new taxpayer-friendly programs to help people who owe on taxes.
That's true, Donna. They have programs that taxpayers may qualify for that can actually stop collection activity and prevent bank levies. However, there are strict guidelines to qualify. It's imperative to utilize an IRS expert to ensure the guidelines are met, or you could miss out on tax resolution programs that can help you. We have used these programs in the past to save our clients thousands of dollars, and we'll do the same for you.
My friends, let the experts at IRS Problem Solvers help you with your tax issues. Call 877-6-SOLVER, schedule your appointment, and receive Phil's book, God, Money, and You, 101 Spiritual Answers to Your Financial Questions. Again, that's 877-6-SOLVER, online at StopIRSPain.com. IRS Problem Solvers, 877-6-SOLVER.
You're smart, you're busy, and don't have time to...
wondering about the trips and prizes we're giving away on K-Love. Those prizes are just a fun way to get you involved. There's no donation required to win. And K-Love never uses your donations to buy these prizes. Every prize is supplied by generous donors who want their donations to go even further and to encourage you to invest in K-Love. Rules are at klove.com. Are you ready to get involved?
Yes.
Give on your phone or tablet at klove.com or call 800-525-5683.
Hey, K-Love family, I'm John Reddick, and I want to share a little bit about my song, I Believe It, The Life of Jesus.
I believe in the life of Jesus. I believe that he conquered death.
I remember someone asking me why I believe in Jesus the way I do, and I told him, to be honest, as I watched the thread that God has been weaving over my life, I can't explain it away as coincidence. I have to give the glory to God.
I believe that he is the Son of God.
I believe it, The Life of Jesus.
K-Love is a smile. Your six-year-old breaks down because her socks don't match.
I don't like my socks!
Just put them on.
And you're running late for work. You hop in the car, the radio is on, and the song is talking to you.
Here's a call from my anxious heart.
A smile. A song. Encouragement. All because somebody gave. Will you be next? Call now to fund your K-Love at 800-525-5683. Or you can give online at klove.com.
This makes me laugh every time I hear it. I don't want to wear these socks! Just so you know, as they get older, that doesn't change.
Oh,
if you think they'll grow out of it, nope.
And does the smell continue?
Oh, the smell! Oh, absolutely.
We're in the smell stage right now, my family.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, three boys, very fragrant.
Oh, well I can tell you... Yeah, girls kind of have their own as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, they especially when they're athletics.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, it's good.
Great.
Something to look forward to, Amy Jo. Wait till they grow up. Positive, encouraging K-Love. Good morning to Skip and Amy, celebrating today the fact that, first of all, more than anything else, we get to spend another day together.
Yes.
And that really means the world to me because, man, you know, you go through life as a semi-professional curmudgeon and think to yourself, look, you know, it's... Don't try and be happy around me. And I can't help it.
Mm.
I can't help it. You know, this joy that spreads every time you hear a song, every time you hear a story, every time the phone rings and we answer it, someone is just giving us some sort of joy. And that comes directly from him. And how can you possibly be in a bad mood?
And you can smile knowing, oh, I can play a part in that. And for years and years, somebody has been giving to keep your K-Love on the air. And now is your opportunity. We're asking for you to give. klove.com. That's where Miss Ann just gave. Thank you, Miss Ann. Patricia, she called 800-525-5683. And right now, we are looking. You have not missed out. There is room for you. The final 50 in this hour, investing $15 a month. And this song to make sure that you are counted in.
Yes.
Because we're talking gas.
I know, and not the kind you get with bad pizza.
Nope. This is the good kind.
This is the good kind that gets you from here to there.
Yes.
A member of our K-Love family stepped up and said, look, you know, let's do something fun. I'm going to pay for the gas for one person for the rest of the year. And if they just help fund K-Love, Bob's your uncle. You're in.
And why? Why would you give? I mean, it does sound kind of crazy giving to a radio station. This is just a sweet little simple message. Miss Chelsea, thank you. Good morning, Chelsea. She's given at klove.com. And she just said, my heart is heavy today. And just listening to my K-Love, even for just a little bit, it makes my heart less heavy.
Oh, man.
I wake up on a pretty regular basis with something heavy on my heart.
Yeah.
And throughout the day, if you turn on the news or you scroll through social media or you talk to your children or your friend and your heart gets heavy because of the pain and the destruction and the yuck in this world and just life sometimes is hard and your heart's heavy. And Miss Chelsea... Thank you for your honesty, for being so transparent.
Mm.
My heart's heavy today. And she paused for just a moment because she said, even listening to K-Love for just a little moment, it makes my heart less heavy. Chelsea, we're praying for you. We love you. We get it. Boy, we've all had those heavy hearts. And she's giving because she wants to make sure on those days when her heart is heavy that she can turn on her K-Love and get just a little bit of encouragement. And she's also making sure that her K-Love is there for millions of others that wake up and they feel heavy and overwhelmed and stressed out and not sure where to turn. And all those stories of accidentally finding K-Love, right?
Yeah.
Connecting so many people with Jesus and your heart feels just a little bit lighter.
Yep.
because you feel that peace and hope. That is why you give. 800-525-5683 or Caleb.com. Just wish that we could hug you, Miss Chelsea.
I'm telling you, we reach out, hug you, squeeze you, hold you so close, and tell you it's going to be okay.
Gotcha.
And to think that what you're going through right now, you have the presence of mind to say, I just want to give. I just want to give in case there's someone else feeling the way I'm feeling right now. That's grace.
Yep. You're a beautiful person, Miss Chelsea.
We would ask if has there been a moment in your life, maybe recently, maybe a long, long time ago, where you had that feeling just like Chelsea? You felt like, man, I am unloved, I'm ugly, I'm going through some really bad stuff right now, and God, I could use as much help as I possibly can. And then the voice of Toby Mac reaches out and grabs you.
Oh, yeah.
Or Chris Tomlin. I'm home. You hear a song about Jesus. You hear songs about home. You hear songs about love and warmth and how he cares and he loves you so, so much.
Truth, right? This world is filled with lies, and junk. There are a few places that you can go and you can find truth and you can be filled up with the good stuff, with love and joy and peace and patience. That's what you're filled up with when you listen to your Caleb, and now you get to invest. You get to invest. I love Miss Rita. She just gave and she said, I'm so excited to give. This is your opportunity. You haven't missed out. $15 a month in this song to make sure that you're counted in. Why? For more Caleb and more Jesus. More Jesus. But also, in to win gas for the rest of the year. A sweet friend donating that $2,400 in free fuel. Don't want you to miss it. 800-525-5683. Or Caleb.com.
With this member of our Caleb family donating this gas, making a significant investment, knowing that Caleb is not funded yet.
Yeah.
Not funded yet, doing this tax-deductible gift, saying, look, here's $2,400. Can you match that? People are stepping up in big ways, big, big ways. Ron is doing $360. Hey, Janet, $500.
Yes, Janet!
Look at it. Meredith is in Ohio, $1,000. Andrea in Georgia, $1,000. People are stepping up, taking the lead. Can you do that? Are you in a place right now to say, you know what? I'm going to take the lead. That $2,400 in gas, I'm going to match it right now. Can you do that? Will you do that? Pray about that. And then if you can, make that commitment. 800-525-5683 or KLOVE.com.
Most giving for the very first time, investing in listener-funded Caleb. This is your moment. So when you have that heavy heart, those days that are extra hard are those days that are extra great. You can turn on your Caleb and you are jamming out and you're feeling encouraged. You're feeling blessed. $15 a month. That's what we're asking for right now. Or you could do a single gift, $180. That works too. And get you in to win gas for the rest of the year. 800-525-5683.
Looking for 50 people. 50 people to make the commitment. $15 a month. That's 50 cents a day, man.
It's doable, I think.
Oh, it is.
For most people, I think that it's doable. It's just taking that moment. And at Caleb.com, Skipper, I think it's about a minute. That's all it takes for you to give.
That's all it takes. You know, the average American household has $53 and change laying around. I've read that a million years ago, and it always strikes me as strange. I can tell you right now, I got a jar of quarters, sits in where I put my briefcase every day, full of quarters. I'm going like, that's 3 months of funding Caleb right there.
And where else?
I don't know, and why are we yelling?
I get a little over the top.
No, it's all right. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. Here, let's take a minute. Let's take 1 minute and really, really reset the table. Hold on. Stop. In 1 minute, you could have such an impact on the lives of literally millions of people.
With a couple quarters.
That's power.
Yes.
That's incredible. But more than that, look at what you're doing for yourself, for your family and your friends. Millions? Hey, that's a bonus. That's whipped cream topping.
Yep.
That's what that is.
Yep.
But the heart of it, the meat of it happens in the backseat of your car. Looking at you through the rearview mirror, smiling and singing along in this 60 seconds. Let's make this commitment together. 800-525-5683, KLOVE.com. 50 cents, two quarters a day. You could help change the world. And that sounds really kind of heady and, okay, slightly ridiculous if you're just listening, but man, it's true. Do it now.
50 spots are open. Is there room for you? Yes. Have 50 people responded?
Nope.
No way. But you, there's a reason you are still listening. There's a reason for you to give right now because your K-Love has changed you. It makes a difference in your family. It makes a difference in your own heart. $15 a month, a single gift, $180 works too, and in to win gas for the rest of the year. In this song to make sure that you're counted in, don't miss it. 800-525-5683, or really the easiest way to do it, KLOVE.com.
Come on, I can have my door today. Gonna let it in. Where do you wanna see my love? But I ain't gonna let it win. It's on my best, it's on my best, it's on my best, it's on my
best. Gaga, gaga.
Conciertos, K-Love 107.5.
Quisiera que tú vivas.
hasta hoy soy feliz, aunque tengo tranquila mi conciencia, sé que pude haber yo hecho más por ti. Oscura soledad estoy viviendo, la misma soledad de tu sepulcro. Tú eres el amor del cual yo tengo el más triste recuerdo de Acapulco. Como quisiera
y estamos a punto de regalarte un par de invitaciones para que veas al maestro, Master of the Masters, Ricardo Arjona, en concierto. Pero antes, te quiero decir que la próxima semana, aquí en Levántate,
¿qué?
Tenemos una sorpresa. Tenemos una sorpresota para todos ustedes. Un regalito muy especial, ¿ok? Eso es la próxima semana. Pero bueno. Calentemos el ambiente con Ricardo Arjona esta semana.
Que viene de gira en su gira Blanco y Negro Volver Tour 2023 el 7 de mayo en el Crypto.com Arena. Los boletos están a la venta en ricardoarjona.com.
Y Vicente Fernández, don Vicente Fernández, le va a hacer ganar este par de boletos con la primera canción. Nomás nos la dicen cuál es la primera canción del mini concierto de don Vicente Fernández.
¿En cuánto tiempo?
Menos de 7 minutos.
Al día que sale espacio, qué historia ser un bar.
Lovero, contigo hicimos historia en el concierto privado de Pepe Aguilar.
Por mujeres como tú.
Una noche inolvidable, llena de alegría, familia, amor y Pepe Aguilar.
Gracias a Kelly por tantos años de apoyarnos, de poner nuestra música, de permitirnos comunicar a la gente en todo el área de Los Ángeles.
De parte de Isaac Álvarez.
Gracias.
Fernanda Kelly.
Gracias.
Jorge Velázquez.
Muchas gracias.
Donna G.
Muchas gracias.
Luis Sandoval.
Gracias.
Hayasí.
Gracias.
Orlando Panda. Y Denise Reyes. Gracias. Gracias por todo el cariño, Los Ángeles. Gracias por siempre estar con nosotros. 107.5 K-Love.
La cabina de tráfico está patrocinada por los defensores. Te lastimas en un accidente, llama al 1-800-636-3636 y problema resuelto. Buenos días, para ti que conduces por Mid-City, un accidente por el 10 direcciones a la altura de la calle Arlington. El sur de Los Ángeles también reporta tráfico lento esta mañana. Hay por el 110 norte entre la calle Florence y Exposition Boulevard. Y para ti que manejas por Buena Park, lentitud sobre el 5 sur a la altura de Artesia Boulevard. Te informo, Lisa Alvarado.
Pisa.